We're surrounded by great computing technologies that have enormous impacts on our lives and enable us to do things unimaginable just a few years ago. They also change us. They change how we live, what information we see, and how we interact with each other. What's the impact of these technologies on society? Are they having the effects we want? Are there unintended consequences?
There are a lot of critical societal problems that computer science can really play an important role in helping us solve.
You know, things like children with not enough to eat, things like people moving from country to country and not having a place to live. And we try to solve those traditionally by just building new technology. New technology is not sufficient. You really have to understand what's going on in those environments, culturally, socially, economically, politically, both to make technology that makes a difference and to resolve the problem.
Students in our Societal Computing PhD program are taking on these challenges. They're doing critical research that's changing the world. They're asking the right questions and applying machine learning, statistics, and network analysis techniques to find answers. They're designing algorithms and systems and deploying them in the world to expand our notion of what's possible.
So right now, increasingly, we're seeing automation. We're seeing situations where people depend more on computing to work in the way that they expect. What we need are people who understand the complexity of the algorithms that are being used, but people who are also sensitive to the societal needs that people have as individuals to make sure that that software doesn't harm people, doesn't disenfranchise people, and so on.
Well, I think privacy is something that most people value, and it's not always obvious when it is slowly eroding. And so I think it's really important that that we're paying attention, that we're considering the privacy issues as we develop these new services and tools, and think about ways that we can offer these great tools while at the same time protecting people's privacy.
These new modes of production where people independently just create dependencies, use things, and produce new stuff in this unmanaged way, it's great for productivity. It's been fantastic for creating good things quickly. But we don't really understand the kinds of risks it's creating or the ways that we can manage it better.
One of the issues that is really very close to my heart is how can we as individuals keep up with the complexity of data flows that we interact with during the course of our daily lives. The challenge, obviously, is that because of the variety of scenarios that we interact with, because of the variety of services that we interact with, and the very complex privacy policies, it is absolutely impossible for a regular human being to actually keep up with that level of complexity.
We actually have a huge project right now on identifying members who are ISIS supporters online so that we can identify these kind of extremist groups, who are members of them, identify what their propaganda is, and help design and influence counter-messaging strategy to reduce the overall threat.
One of the projects that we're doing in the space of applied systems is that on smart buildings, where the essential idea is that how do we make our buildings, the current buildings that we have that aren't very smart, much more performative and much more efficient by turning them into programmable systems just like you have a computer system today.
Their preparation at Carnegie Mellon has enabled our students to take leadership roles, taking academic positions at leading universities like Harvard, Berkeley, Vanderbilt, UC San Diego, West Point, KAIST in South Korea, Peking University in China. They're doing groundbreaking research at companies like Google, IBM, and Microsoft. And they're joining or starting their own ventures to deploy new technologies in the world.
So the student who would flourish in our societal computing program is somebody who has a deeply technical background and interest.
But they realize they're missing something. They're not just satisfied with additional computer science education.
They almost always have some other burning interest as well, whether it's in privacy or whether it's in network analysis or in policy.
They should have a deep interest in one or more of the many different social sciences.
They combine this deep technical interest with some practical or applied sphere, and bringing those together in societal computing has worked out really well for them.
Students who are interested in going out there and solving societal problems using their technical skills, those are the students we're looking for.